Hello students, today we are going to see the gear materials and law of gearing. So what is the materials we choose to manufacture the gear? Today we are going to see again. Today we are going to see law of gearing. So this is a derivation. This derivation is too much important, okay, as a exam point of view. So first thing, we are going to see the gear materials. The material used for the manufacturing of gears depends upon the strength and service condition, like wear, noise, etc. Okay, so the gears may be manufactured from metallic or non-metallic materials. The metallic gears with cut teeth are commercially obtainable in cast iron, steel and bronze. Okay, so this gear, as per the service condition and strength, we can use materials like cast iron, steel and bronze. The non-metallic materials like wood, rawhide, compressed paper and synthetic resins like nylon are used for gears, especially for reduction in noise. Whenever we want to reduce the noise, we can use the gear materials, that is non-metallic materials like wood, rawhide, compressed paper and synthetic resins like nylon. The cast iron is widely used for the manufacturing of gears due to its good wearing properties. That is, wearing property of cast iron is very good. So the cast iron material is used to manufacturing gear widely. And excellent machinability and ease of production, producing complicated shapes by casting method. Okay, so we can produce any complicated gear size with this cast iron. The cast iron gears with cut teeth may be employed where smooth action is not important. Whenever we want, whenever there is no necessity, where the application or the application of or functioning of the gear is not smooth, at that condition we can use the cast iron material. The steel is used for high strength gears, and steel may be plain carbon steel or alloy steel. The steel gears are usually heat treated in order to combine properly the toughness and tooth hardness. In the case of this gear manufacturing, we are going to go for the heat treatment process, that is gas hardening process will be there, or all hardening process will be there. This is heat treatment process will be there for the toughness and tooth hardness. The phosphor bronze is widely used for warm gears. This warm gears, in order to reduce wear of warm gears, which will be excessive with cast iron or steel. The phosphor bronze material is used to manufacturing the warm gears. Why it is there? Reduction of wear, to reduce the wear. In the case of, if we take the cast iron or steel, then wear will be excessive. In that case, we will use the phosphor bronze for the warm gear. Okay, now we are going to see the constant condition for constant velocity ratio of tooth wheels, that is nothing but law of gearing. So this is diagram. See here, this is what body 1 and this is what body 2. Okay, this is diagram. In that diagram, what we see, this is NN, this NN is what normal, and this TT is nothing but what tangent at this point C and D. So law of gearing states the condition which must be fulfilled by the gear tooth profile to maintain a constant angular velocity ratio between two gears. This is nothing but, this is what simply a statement of this what law of gearing. The law of gearing states that, what is states, the condition which must fulfill by the gear tooth profile. This, suppose this is a body 1 and body 2. These are, suppose this is gear 1 and gear 2, they both are in meshing with each other, then what, they fulfill the conditions that maintain a constant angular velocity ratio between two gears. Means they fulfill the condition that they have to maintain a constant angular velocity ratio. Figure shows two bodies 1 and 2 representing a portion of two gears in a mesh. This is body 1, we already seen this is body 1 and body 2, and both are meshes. Okay, so see here, this point C will be here, okay, and here point D will be here, both are in contact with each other. A point C on the tooth profile of gear 1, that is this point C of the tooth profile of gear 1 is in contact with point D. This is what a point D will be here, okay, point D of the tooth profile of gear 2. The two curves in contact at point C or D, this is point C or D, okay, must have a common normal at the point. So here, see here, common normal will be there. This is what NN, this NN pass through this point C and D. This is what nothing but what common normal at the point. Okay, let it be NN. This is what common normal. Let see here, omega 1, this is equal to what instantaneous angular velocity of gear 1. So see here, omega 1 will be here, okay, this is nothing but what instantaneous angular velocity of this gear 1. This one in clockwise direction, okay. So see here, omega 2 is, where is omega 2? This omega 2 is nothing but what instantaneous angular velocity of the gear 2. This is what counterclockwise direction means. See here, this omega 1 is in this direction and omega 2 is in that direction, okay, both are in opposite direction. That is, omega 1 is in clockwise direction and omega 2 is nothing but what, in counterclockwise direction. Counterclockwise direction, that means anticlockwise direction. VC is equal to what linear velocity of C. See here, this is point C, okay, and this is what VC. Okay, VC is nothing but what linear velocity of C. Next, VD is nothing but what linear velocity of point D. Where is D? This is what VD at this point D. Then VC is equal to omega 1 into AC in the direction perpendicular to AC or at an angle alpha to NN. So see here, we know that linear velocity V is equal to R into omega, okay. So VC is equal to what R into omega. R is nothing but what radius. So see here in this diagram, so this VC is nothing but what this angular velocity omega 1, this omega 1 into R. R is nothing but what this AC, okay, AC into this omega 1. Or again we can see that as at an angle alpha to NN, this is what angle alpha will be here, okay, this angle alpha will be there, this angle with what common normal NN, okay. So next is what VD is equal to omega 2 into BD. Again same, we already seen that V is equal to what R into omega. So V is nothing but what here, VD is equal to R. R is what here, in that case BD, this BD is nothing but what radius into this angular velocity omega 2, or at an angle beta to NN. Now if the curve surface of the teeth of two gears are to remain in contact, what is the condition? If the curved surface of the teeth of two gears are to be remain in contact, okay, one surface may slide relative to another along the common tangent TT. That means one surface may be slide relative to other, okay, along the common tangent TT. Where is common tangent? This TT is nothing but what common tangent. This is passing through this point C and D. This is passing from this point C and D. Okay. So component of V along NN is equal to VC cos alpha. Next, this first is what VC. This VC is equal to VC into cos of alpha. Okay, next is what component of VD. The component of VD along NN, this is NN is nothing but a common normal. This is nothing but what VD into cos of beta. Okay. So relative motion along NN is equal to cos alpha minus VC alpha VC cos alpha minus VD cos of beta. Okay. So this is nothing but what relative motion. That means both are slide on each other. Okay. So we got, this is what a relative motion with each other. So this is relative motion along NN is equal to this VC cos alpha minus VD cos beta. So put the values of cos alpha and cos beta from this triangle. Draw perpendiculars AE and BF on NN. This is common normal from the points AB respectively. So see here AE. Where is AE? So A to E. Okay, this is perpendicular to NN. So NN perpendicular to NN, this AE. Okay, from this point A. Again next BF. Where is BF? Here is BF. This is perpendicular to was NN from this point B. Okay, we draw here. Then angle CAE and this angle DBF. This angle CA is equal to alpha and this is nothing but what? Beta. Okay. For proper contact, VC cos alpha minus VD cos beta is equal to 0. For the proper contact, what is that? The VC cos alpha minus VD cos alpha cos beta is equal to 0. This is for the proper contact. That is relative motion is equal to 0. So put here value of VC. VC is nothing but what? Omega 1 into AC into this cos alpha minus VD. What is the value of VD? VD is what? Omega 2 into PD into this cos beta is equal to 0. Where VC is equal to what? Omega 1 into AC and VD is equal to what? Omega 2 into BD. So see here, omega 1 into AC. Now cos alpha is nothing but what? AE divided by AC. So see here, see this triangle. So in this triangle, we want to find out what? Cos of alpha. This cos of alpha is nothing but what? Adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So this is nothing but what? AE divided by AC. So put the value in this equation here. Okay. Minus omega 2 into BD into here BF divided by BD. This is nothing but what? Cos beta. So cos beta, see here, adjacent side. Okay. This BF, this is what adjacent side. Okay. Divide this hypothesis. BD is equal to 0. So simply what here? AC AC will get cancel here. BD BD will cancel here. So what we get here? Omega 1 into AE minus omega 2 into BF is equal to 0. We got here. So simply we got here omega. If we get the ratios, omega 1 divided by omega 2 is equal to BF divided by AE is equal to BP divided by AP. So see here, from this we got here, and BF by AE is equal to BP by AP from the similar triangles. Also the triangle, see here, triangle AEP, this triangle AEP, see here. Okay. And again triangle B BFP. So where is BFP? This BFP. Both are the similar triangles. Okay. So from these triangles, what we get here? This BP divided by AP, okay, is equal to this FP divided by this EP. Okay, so see here, we already got here one equation, and from this equation we can put here. So what we get here, omega 1 divided by omega 2 is equal to BF divided by AE is equal to BP divided by AP is equal to FP divided by EP. So see here, thus it is seen that the center line AB, the center line AB divided at point P by the common normal, okay, in the inverse ratio of the angular velocity of two gears. So the statement is, what the statement says that this point P, okay, divides this line AB, okay, this point P divides the line AB, okay, in inverse ratio of angular velocities of two gear. If it is desired that angular velocity of two gears remain constant, the common normal at point of contact of two teeth should always pass through fixed point, that is point P, which divides the line of center in the inverse ratio of angular velocity of two gears. This is nothing but what the statement of this, what, law of Geary. Okay, the common normal at point of contact of two teeth should always pass through the fixed point P, which divides the line of center in the inverse ratio of angular velocities of two gears. As seen earlier, we already seen that P is also the point of contact of two piece circles, which divides the line of centers in the inverse ratio of angular velocities of two circles and is a pitch point. This point P is nothing but what? Point, pitch point. So thus, for the constant angular velocity ratio of two gears, the common normal at point of contact of two mating teeth must pass through the pitch point. This is nothing but what? This is what? Statement of the law of Geary. Thank you. In next lecture, we will see the velocity of sliding.